Yeah, now we've got the cover off the bike, you can see that this is the solution to the problem that we came up with. So, yeah, working from John's designs, and we've managed to create something that is real from the aesthetic forms that we've drawn on paper. The forms combined with the engineering constraints which have created what we've got in front of us, which we're incredibly proud of. So
it does look fantastic to see it in three dimensions now, to see the finished article.
We are already vastly improved on what currently exists. And then with the duct itself, the multiplying effect of the benefit is how we end up at 70%. With quite a blunt nose, intentionally, to separate the air and run it around the front swing arm fairing covers. And the important thing is, on a superbike, you would probably run the air down the bike, and at about this point here where your foot pegs would be, there would be no fairings here, and all the air from this point onwards, perhaps diagonally up to the rider, this point behind here would be seen as a low influence on the overall performance.
But from plan view, the top, it's like a fish,
yeah,
isn't it? So it smooths down to a tail. And then, of course, it doesn't need an extended tail because we can fill that with the exit of the Venturi.
We engineered the bike so that even at the very rear of the motorcycle, we've managed to put the entire drivetrain inside the left hand. And that means that we've managed to reduce the width of the rear swing arm to the Hayabusa by 4 inches, so 100 mil.
So what's fascinating for me is we're optimising, like some race bikes will do, the exterior skin, but we're equally optimising the interior skins,
yeah,
to avoid, as you say, swirl. We had a bit of swirl coming off the back wheel, but the whole front end is designed to make the most of both internal and external airflow. That was one of the key reasons why you had to go for the hub centre steering. Front forks just wouldn't work on this.
No.
And going back to your layer, mechanically, engineering-wise, it made a lot of sense to go from the front axle into a battery box, rear axle.
Yeah.
You've got a solid platform then upon which we can put the duct with rider.
Yeah.
No interference from forks, no odd mechanical pathway through the bike. How comfy is it to sit on, Rob?
It's not overly comfortable, but if you want to go fast, you're not that bothered about comfort, so. Its primary purpose is to go quickly, so therefore the unusual shapes and volumes which perhaps aesthetically are not conventional to superbikes.
But there's a good reason for them.
Yeah, once the rider's on, it creates an incredibly efficient shape.
That was the challenge I enjoyed, was how do you put a package together there that doesn't affect that functionality in anything. It makes it better in an interesting and unusual new shape. But the shapes all have good reasons.